In its fourth year, the Imagine RIT Festival continues to draw crowds by the thousands. YNN's Ann Litiluza shows us some of the interesting exhibits that got people talking and thinking.
There was a lot to imagine with nearly 350 exhibits in the Rochester Institute of Technology.
We're using polynomial texture mapping.
For students, it's an arena to showcase their innovation and creativity. Here at the Freshman Imaging Project, a camera on top of this dome uses 23 different light sources to help see texture really well.
You can use it for forensics. It's used a lot for old manuscripts. For instance, if a manuscript was washed clean, we can use this technology to see what was written on it before.
U.S. Senator Chuck Schumer says Imagine RIT shows just how important the college is for the future of the Rochester area.
We had 65,000 jobs in Kodak 30 years ago, and they're not there anymore. And the only real hope is sort of high-end, businesses that deal with technology, and Rochester's doing pretty well in that area.
Schumer is talking about people like the Salami twins, president and vice president of the amateur radio club, K2GXT.
Being here at Imagine RIT, we can not only show what our club has done, our club's done an amazing job.
It's been a lot of teamwork.
We have a really awesome design.
The exhibit is a helium balloon that will travel at 100,000 feet in the air. That's three times the height of a jet airliner.
It will rise up, it will send back temperature data, location data, altitude. We'll be able to track it live over the internet.
Attached is an HD camera that will take continuous video throughout the 3 to 4 hour long flight.
We will see the curve of the Earth and we'll see the black space, and there's going to be almost a vacuum of space. It's very close to a vacuum, and the balloon will be about 3 feet wide right before it blows up and comes parachuting back down.
The Amateur Radio Club won the Academic Award for its work and innovation. The twins say the experiment took 4 months to design by hand.
When we had to design this, we had to deal with temperatures of between negative 50 and negative 60 degrees Fahrenheit. And, you know, it has to work. If it doesn't work, we don't get it back.
It's a project that will likely help these students soar now and in their future careers. Ann Litiluza, YNN.